Alright guys, let's get it started. The first game between me and Palindru Chvitanga on the beautiful map Falls of Eisen. Random Mirror, Reds versus Blue, Romania versus Turkey. Let's do this. Wow, really early stream today. Yes, Zero, hi, welcome. Oh, we get to play the Isengard faction. Oh, nice. Nice. The White Hand of Saruman. I will try to make you proud, my friend. So let's wall check immediately. That's very important. Oh, that's a good faction. So we're gonna cancel the Uruk pits and build a, the furnaces and build up a Uruk pit instead. And we will always pick up the war chant from the spellbook. That's the key to victory. So if he's Gondo, it's a great matchup for us. If he's Rohan, it's a nice matchup overall. We will get some crossbowmen on the field next. What you can always do is, after building the Lamir Mill, I mean, we don't have the money right now. There is no need of us walking downside, right? So we can move forward instead and try to catch those peasants or soldiers. Orcs. These are Uruk-hai. Their armor is thick and their shields broad. Oh yeah, their armor is thick and their shields broad. How does it work? Clicking on your opponent base. Yeah, when the mouse is jumping, then you know it's a good faction. You know, that's what you need to know. Oh, that's a Rohan faction. I think it's a nice matchup. But I believe crossbowman start here doesn't make too much sense. So what we need to do, because we don't have the money now for the second Uruk-hai. Crossbowman start is a nice choice against soldiers because he has only two soldiers. But Palindru can now easily spam lots of extra peasants. That means we will now have to, you know, creep after dealing with those peasants. Make some extra workers. Okay, nice. So now we can go for a creep. We have still war chanted units and we will get to, we will need to get some more Uruk-hai on the field afterwards. Switch the battle formation. Fire at will. And let's do this. Okay, so almost the money we need for the Uruk-hai. Come on, please, please. Give me the money. Alrighty, nice. Creeping this is actually quite nice for us because we will get the chance to get a level 2 combo battalion, which is quite impressive. And we can combine them later on with the Uruk-hai. I mean, depends. One of these units is going to hit level 2 now. And then we can combine them with each other. And this way, we can get a level 2 combo battalion. Make one more Uruk-hai. Hello, Saya. Welcome. Okay, let's give it actually to the Uruk-hai potentially. I mean, it doesn't matter. Okay, that's nice. So now we get the money. We group. Uh-oh. Alright, maybe we shouldn't have grouped them. That's, you know, the problem is when you group the units like that, they are way slower. But we have enough money for the furnace. And creeping this was actually quite helpful. We might be able to save this one, hopefully. But I need to kill the attacking peasants first, before anything else. And then we will get the level 2. And once again, we want to make sure to kill these peasants first who are attacking our mill. And this way, we will hopefully be able to protect this. One more Uruk-hai. And we will also need some more workers. And we should be fine. We should be fine. Level 2 combo battalion is actually quite nice in a situation like that. Now we can move on. And creep as much as we possibly can. And after this one, our Uruk pit is going to get level 2. That's nice, because that's going to give us the chance to recruit some pikemen, you know? Wild Wargs! So we should be fine. We can also repair this one, so it's going to heal up faster. Okay, Uruk pit is expanded. That's great. Now we can start recruiting some pikemen, finally. Kill this, please, first. And pikemen coming up next. I mean, we are in a good spot. Even when he tries to fight us with the Rohirrim against the combo, we can always war chant them and we will be good to go. There's their camp, so we can try to attack this and throw some attention. In this matchup, it's very important to deny Rohan as many creeps as we possibly can, because this way we can also delay his Elven Warrior special summon from the spellbook of Rohan. And once again, you want to make sure to keep this mills protected as Isengard against good factions. Let's leave it to the combo battalion. This way they're gonna hit almost level 3. There is no need of us getting this. You know what I'm saying? Not very necessary. Get the money. It should be fine. Okay, here's Rohirrim on the field, but it's also fine. Let's make one furnace and one tower in the front side, one tower in the back side. No, better safe than sorry. Almost level 3. That's great. And we have now also, you know, Spearman units to defend ourselves. And with the combat battalion, we want to make sure to creep as much as we possibly can. Hey, Kumarian, welcome. What's poppin'? We are playing some BFME 1, me and Palindru. But if anybody else wants to play later on, you are more than welcome. We need more pikemen, though. And then we might also need some work riders later on, if you will recruit some peasants to deal with the spearmen. With the Uruk pikemen units. Let's make one more tower. You know, I like to be in a safe spot. Yeah, I'm gonna hit level 3 now. Let's scout with these units. I'm getting hungry. Alright. Give those Uruks their pikes. Their damage output against the buildings isn't the greatest, but we can always put them next to the building. Hey man, too strong for you. Thank you for the resub for the 4th month now. Appreciate that. Means a lot to me.
Too strong for you. Just resubscribed for 4 months. Ahoy, Kappa.
Ahoy, Kappa. Right, we will get the last hit. I mean, it's fine. I will just let him kill some of the units. It doesn't matter that much. But we have a level 3 unit now. We can also buy this mill. And now we can peel back a little bit and try to put some pressure with those units. With this combat battalion. And we will be building up now the Uruk pit. I mean, the Warg pit. Sorry, not the Uruk pit. And, you know, the most important building in our base is the Uruk pit, definitely. We want to make sure that we have enough protection for this one. We were able to creep this one in the middle, and this one at the bottom side. So, 3 creeps. Yes, I'm Rohirrim, but that's fine. We have also enough power points now for the industry. Let's pick it up and use it immediately, shall we? Oh, he was already creeping this one. Don't want to trample this. You don't want to trample this. You don't want to trample this. You don't want to trample this. Be careful with your... Oh, no. Hello, darkness, my old friend. Oh? Oh, nice one. It was great. Oh, he's not paying attention. Valindru Chvitanga, what are you doing? Valindru Chvitanga, be careful. Oh, now he's running into the towers. We cannot maybe catch him. Oh, he's going to get tilted after this one. Oh, he's using... Okay, never mind. He's using heal. He has also... Oh, okay. I see you. You know what? I can get my anti-hero on the field just as easy as that. Oh no, Rohirrim are gonna get killed or what? Okay, we can also kill Styrian, by the way, if he's being stuck like that. Oh, he was running into the tower. Was trying desperately to save the Rohirrim. Oh, he's running it down and Styrian. Alright, but Indru is gonna be tilted. You already know what's gonna happen, right? He's gonna leave this one very, very soon. Trust me on that one. GG, yeah, it's hard now. He can't win this game anymore. He lost a lot. He lost 2 battalions of Rohirrim. He lost his Styrian. You know, but he might try, maybe. He might try. We have also Warg Riders cooking from the Warg Pit. We should be in a fine spot. Let's build some more towers. Not that we need them, but, you know, like, once again, I would like to be in a safe spot. So now we can snowball our lead easily to victory. Let's pick up this meal next. Okay, we can get this farm back. Hobbit was able to destroy that, but that's fine. We get a second Warg Rider on the field, and then we will be just switching to get the outpost control. Okay, we should be fine. He can't deal with us. He has no upgrades. Let's get this. Oh yeah, let's get this one as well. And after this Warg Rider, we will get... Wait a second, I need to move. They were not in position. We will lose this mill, unfortunately, but it is how it is. Oh, come on, pikemen, move. Oh, some peasants. I see them. Okay, we destroyed this one. That's fine. Now we will have to kill this units. Demolish the Warg pits and... Oh, what are you doing? Valindru Chvitanga, don't do that. He's running it down pretty much. Okay, we gotta kill those peasants with the... He lost another battalion, unfortunately, for him. We have so much money, holy moly. Okay, armory coming up next. Can we protect this? I guess we can. Yeah, that's fine, that's fine. And then we will... I mean, it's very important for us Is that a Shadow and Flame mod? No, that's not Shadow and Flame mod. That's a normal BFME on the patch 1.06, yes. Okay. So we can start sieging Veris. Armory almost up. Okay, Lords. Oh, he has armor. I see you. I mean, he has plates, not armor. We can buy all the upgrades. We have so much money. We should be absolutely fine. Oh, you want to go for a base rush potentially? Oh, Theoden, what are you doing, bro? Don't do that, Theoden. Oh, I can use Soul Ability, my friend. That's going to make our war cry. This hits like an absolute track. Okay, we have Industry. Use it again. As soon as it's available. He can turn and fight us, by the way, if he wants to. Yeah, he's going to do that. That's why we need to peel back. He has leadership, plus he has bleeds. That's why he's so strong. Now we can keep chasing. You know what? I can also use Palantir here. Just use it. Palantir is going to make them run faster, and this way we can catch them. You can also use Hold Ability for more damage. Fire arrows purchased. He's losing a lot. Oh, never mind. He's fine. Let's get the map control back, shall we? So we can give them armor and fire. And Lords can also stay right in front of the gate. This way we can body block. So let's wait for the blades. And after the blades, we can make the transition into the siege vortex. This way we can start sieging the Rohan. Oh, okay. Oh, no, 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 no. Don't go inside. Oh, you want to fight? I'm down. Okay, buy this. Let's capture this outpost, shall we? They have blades very soon. Now we have the blades watch now. You have no chance against the mighty Uruk-hai. Oh, we crippled him. That's great. Oh, I shouldn't have done it. Oh, I wanted to leave it for Lords, but it's fine. It's fine. So now we have 100% map control. We can buy this outpost and start sieging from there. After getting all the upgrades, we can also demolish our armory. And just chase them all the time. Just why not, you know? Ah, he's fighting us with the peasants, but it's fine. We have armor, so we should be winning this fight. Not a big deal. Let's make some more workers from this one. Let's get this back also. We will lose this one. That's kind of fine, I guess. Yeah, he will kill some males, but I'm down. I'm fine with that. Let's build now the siege vortex at the topside outpost. Imagine if AA make a new Lord of the Ring conquest. I've never played this one, by the way. I only played from Lord of the Rings, the BFME games. That's it. You give them blades too. This way we can fight them potentially. Our Palantir is on cooldown. No, don't kill them. Okay. All right, it's time for a duel. I'm chasing them with the combo battalion, you know? You wanna fight? Uh-oh. Oh, I'm down. You wanna fight? Nice, you will lose them. He's using heal. Okay, now we have to recapture the map control a little bit because we have lost quite a lot. We need to make some more pikemen. That's what it is. Oh, what is he doing? Come on, one more hit. Oh, Lords. Lords is the hero. Open you. Nice. Okay, now we will make some... Let's go old school. Let's go old school, guys. Because that's a nostalgic thing. Let's go for the ladders. Oh, what am I doing? I'm gate rushing. My bad. Sorry. I was not paying attention for a single second. Okay. So let's go for the old school, guys. Let's go for the leathers and get on top of the wall from Rohan, shall we? Let's use industry there. Let's buy this meal back. We have full map control. That's what I like to see. The map is turning into our color, guys, which is a red. Let's give them also blades. We have a... Oh, he's going for the towers now. Okay, I see you were in Druj Vitanga. But it's fine, I'm down. Let's give them bleeds and banners to make them level 2. Okay, now we can use the gate once again, finally. Oh, we have some units damaged here. Give them banners, that way they can respawn over time. Keep gate rushing? No, no, I won't gate rush. I was not paying attention, that's why I did it, you know? Okay, we are waiting for the ladder to come. Oh, we will lose this one, but it's kind of fine, I guess. We will need some more pikemen, because we will keep losing this map control all the time. Let's buy this outpost, shall we? Get there. Okay, we are waiting for the ladder. Hopefully it's not gonna kill it. And we should be fine. Unlucky, we'll see our ladder coming now, but it's too late, my friend. We have already one here. Imagine Legolas here. When we are getting into the wall, they are gonna get really clumped up. And this way, he's building a tower. Okay. Come on, use the gate. Use the gate. Use the thing. These units, they don't want to use it. I can kill this tower with the combos, by the way, if you don't know. We will lose this, but it's fine. Get here. Get here. I want to use War Chant, you know, I want them to be grouped. Now we can use War Chant. And now we can just stay on the wall and destroy everything. He can't even fight us back anymore. Let's do this. Yes, let's go. Pikes can't use ladders. They may. Oh, maybe. I didn't know that. They should be able to use it, though. We will lose this, but it's okay, I guess. We have full map control. Yes, one farm only. That's it. Wrong base, my friends. Yeah. Look at the range. You can actually shoot from there. It's quite nice. I like that. Lurt is almost level 5. Let's kill some archers to get him level 5, shall we? Oh, look, his Rohirrim are shining bright like a diamond. Killing our Vork Riders. Be careful, Vork Riders. We have no Sharku in BFME1, unlike in BFME2 or Rise of the Witch King. We gotta be careful. Let's kill this next. Okay. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Isengard against Rohan. And unlike in the films, my friend, there is no Gandalf who can save you this time. Well played, Palindru. Has been defeated. And Isengard, the White Hand of Saruman, shall rise again. GG's.